35th verse to the 38th verse. Romans 8 chapter, 35th verse to the 38th verse. 35th verse to the 38th verse. When you get it, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I'm so excited about to jump out my skin. Can't contain myself.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You deserve it.
8th chapter, 35th through the 38th. Not going to be for you long. Still on my honeymoon.
That's right, amen.
I didn't bring no Bible or nothing.
You are right.
Hallelujah. I wasn't going to come. But some just kept on telling me to go to church.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We was laying there. My husband was snoring, knocked out.
As always. All right, man, Bishop. Yeah.
I was ready to go.
Okay.
8th chapter, 35th verse and 38th verse. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We're counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all things we are more than conquerors through him that love us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come. This is the behalf of the children of Florida. 17 dead. Hallelujah. All them that are wounded, especially the coach. Hallelujah. That's funeral is today at 2:00. Hallelujah. That used his body as a weapon. Hallelujah. To save some of the children. This goes out to all the children of, hallelujah, that are dying. Hallelujah. That are fighting. Hallelujah. For their life. This message goes out to all the children. Hallelujah. That are standing up. Hallelujah. Trying to protect themselves. Hallelujah. From the guns. Hallelujah. The bullets. Hallelujah. You can't protect yourself from the guns and the bullets because it takes a human being to pull the trigger. Hallelujah. You have to know what you know. The Bible says, hallelujah, the righteous man, hallelujah, has to stand forth and tell the people of this world that nothing can save you but Jesus Christ. Nothing can save you but holiness and hell.
Amen.
Hallelujah. My son, today is, hallelujah, when you know what you know. When you know what you know, hallelujah, you know to get down on your knees and pray before, hallelujah, God may come to your school. You know to get down on your knees as a family and pray together. My father always taught me the family that prays together stays together. It takes prayer, starting in the home. We must pray and turn back to God. We have to forget about ourselves, forget about politics, forget about Trump. We have to forget about everything and go back and fall on our knees and pray like we don't have no sense. Pray ridiculously like we don't have any sense. We got to fall on bended knees. Stop eating so much. Hallelujah. Fast, church. Fast and pray. Pray for young people. We need a policeman to stand up the door with a machine gun guarding the children, guarding every exit at the school. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to go back to the old way and pray without ceasing. Rachel, pray for the children. Refuse to be covered. We must pray. World, pray as the answer. Pray as the key. Pray as your weapon. We must pray. We must pray. Hallelujah. My prayer go out. Hallelujah. To the coach. Hallelujah. That used his body to chill the children. Pray for his family. Pray. Pray, church. know what you know.
Yes.
You can quote the scripture.
Yes.
I'm persuaded. Your child. You don't know. The government could be at your child's school. The government could reach Rhode Island. The Bible tells us, Romans 8 and 38, that Satan, he had but a short time, and he's out there on a warpath.
Yes.
Hallelujah, because you know his time is almost up. You know his time is running out. So he's trying to kill all the children so there won't be prophets, won't be preachers, won't be deacons, won't be missionaries. He's trying to kill all the generation. But church, we must pray. Children, God will take care of your home.
All
right. Let us forget about our children. We always pray for them. Let us pray for the children in Florida.
Yes.
Let's go on a fast for the children in Florida.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because the devil, Satan, he's on a war path. And he on it mighty hard. Because he know he got a short time. Time is almost up. We living in the last and evil days. Hallelujah, we living in the last and evil days. Do you hear what I'm saying? We living in the last and evil days. Everything is going on. Every single thing is going on. I mean everything. Children are afraid to go to school. They're afraid to go to school. Mothers are on the internet. They're talking about walking out as a unit. Hallelujah, as a unison. Asking all the mothers of the world for 17 minutes to walk out of the school and go and sign your children out. Hallelujah, make a stand. Hallelujah. But you're going to have to do better than that. You better get on your knees. Hallelujah, you better stop eating so much. You better learn to fast. Don't drink no water. Don't eat no food for 3 days and pray to God for a change. Pray for God to build a hedge around our children. Do like Rachel in the Bible that was married, hallelujah, to Jacob. She prayed all night, all day, and refused to be covered.
fasting, didn't want no food. Sometimes you can't eat. Sometimes you got to turn it away. Sometimes you got to do this to pray for our children. Safety to pray without ceasing. Cry all day long. Say, Lord, have mercy. Help my children. God, our children. Pray. Go to church with your children. Fall on your bended knees. Turn your heart and mind and soul over to God. Hallelujah. Come together as a family. Hallelujah. And pray, church, and you'll see a change in the world. The Bible said, hallelujah, hallelujah, if my people, which are called by my name, hallelujah, will humble. It takes a strong man, it takes a strong woman to humble itself. Forget about who you are. Forget about you being Jay-Z. Forget about you being Beyonce. Forget about you being, hallelujah, Wesley Snipes. Forget about you being Angela Bassett. Forget about that, hallelujah, and learn to humble yourself. The Bible said, if my people, talking about them that have been buried in the blood wash of Jesus Christ, somebody that went down and submerged in Jesus' name under the liquid grave, came up a new creature, took on the Father's name. Now they're the King's kids. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the people of God. If my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves, hallelujah, and pray. And pray and turn. You got to turn from being prejudiced. You got to turn from talking about Black Lives Matter. You got to turn from being thinking your race is the strongest race and the most intelligent. You got to give that garbage back to Satan. All lives matter. Whether you're African, whether you're Black American, whether you're Latino, whether you're Native American, whether you're Chinese, Asian, Spanish, Black, Greek, Jew, no matter what country you come from, whatever color you wrapped around in, you must fall on your knees, learn to pray without ceasing. Get your Bible, read it to your children, get concerned about this world, what's going on in this world. When you know what you know, if you know the 66 books, you know to pray. Amen. You know to fast. Hallelujah. When you know what you know, then you can save our children. When you know what you know, then you can help other families. When you know what you know, then you'll have the solution from all this killing. Don't stop the guns, but stop the human being that's pulling the trigger behind the gun. And only one can save the human being is God himself. Only one can save the human being is God himself. It take a God, and his name is Dr. Jesus. His name is our Lord Jesus Christ. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, the all-dwelling one, the dispensation of the Spirit, hallelujah, that tells you that Jesus Christ is our Lord, hallelujah. Jehovah got to cry. Allah got to cry. Virgin Mary got to cry. Buddha got to cry. That our Lord is Jesus. Our Lord Jesus, Jesus, oh, so meek and mild, Jesus, Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child. Do you know, do you know, do you know, get to know, got to know, better know, when you know, what you know, when you know, what you know, got to know, the man called Jesus. That's your answer. That's the solution to the world today. It's when you know what you know, then you can win this war that we are going on in the world by calling on the name of Jesus on your knees.